Okay, guys, what we're gonna do is we're gonna be talking about silly monsters. Now, sometimes monsters can be scary, but we're talking about silly monsters, and I have a song for you guys. Have you ever heard of the song Five Little Monkeys Jumping on the Bed?
Yeah.
Well, it's kind of like that one, except it goes, Five Silly Monsters Under the Bed. So can y'all see the words? So it goes, can y'all sing it with me? Do your hands. Go, Five Silly Monsters Under the Bed. It's too dark, the little one said. He ran off to play. So only four little monsters stayed another day. Good. Now we're going to start with, how many monsters do we have now?
Four.
See the picture? Let's go. Four little monsters under the bed. It's too dark, the little one said. He ran off to play. So only three little monsters stayed another day. Now we got
three
monsters. Three silly monsters under the bed. It's too dark, the little one said. He ran off to play. So only two silly monsters stayed another day. Now how many do we have?
Two.
Two silly monsters under the bed. It's too dark, the little one said. He ran off to play. So only one little monster stayed another day. One silly monster under the bed. It's too dark, the little one said. He ran off to play. So zero silly monsters stayed another day. This one's sad. Zero silly monsters under the bed. They all ran off to play. Good. Y'all did great. Did y'all like that? Yeah. So we're going to read this story about a silly monster. It's called, Hey, That's My Monster.
Okay.
Now you see the little boy and the little girl?
Okay.
They have brothers and sisters. So we're going to see what they do with their silly monster. And this is by Amanda Knoll, and it was illustrated by Howard McWilliam. Remember, the author is the one who writes the story, and the illustrator is the one that draws the pictures. It's a pretty good drawer, isn't it? Or artist is what we really should call it. It says, Tonight, when I looked under my bed for my monster, I found this note instead. So long, kid. Gotta go. Someone needs me more than you. Signed, Gabe.
What? Gabe was my monster. Nobody needed him more than me.
Oh, how's he feeling? Kind of sad. Yeah. But someone did need a monster. My sister, Emma. Now, that Emma slept in her toddler bed. She liked to climb out, roam the house, and play noisy games at night. I knew a monster would keep her in bed so she would fall asleep. But not my monster. I had to get Gabe back. I tiptoed across the hall to Emma's room. And she wasn't there. Where's Emma? But Gabe was. I gulped, zoomed across the carpet, and leapt onto Emma's bed before he could get my toes. Gabe, I whispered, please go back to our room. I'll get Emma to go to sleep.
You, he snorted, you're gonna get her to sleep? Ha, that's a good one. But you know what? I like you. So I'll give you three chances. If she's not asleep, I'll be back.
And Gabe was gone. Oh, I don't know if I'd want him to come back to my room. Just then, Emma toddled into the room, and she clearly needed a monster. Maybe she didn't know how to get one, but I did. "Hey, Emma," I said, "let's play. Can you knock on the floor?" Emma knocked on the dinosaur. Can y'all knock on the floor? It worked! I heard some creaking under Emma's bed. Then something sniffled. Something squelched down, dripped. So far, so good, I thought. This monster sounds scary enough for Emma, but Emma kept on playing. Not worried at all. The slime-covered monster slid out and oozed toward Emma.
"Icky,"
she said, wiping one of the monster's noses. "Icky, wipe." Emma wasn't scared at all.
"Excuse me," said the mucus monster. "I didn't catch your name. My name is Agatha,"
said the, she sniffled through noses.
"Time for bed, Emma."
I knew this wouldn't work. But thanks, Emma, nice try, because Emma giggled and wiped her nose some more. But I think we need a monster with claws. Agatha sniffled, and then she was gone. I don't think I'd like that one either. "Emma," I coaxed again. "Knock, knock." And she knocked on the floor with a teapot this time. And I heard more creaking. Can y'all knock on the floor again? Then a slippery tail slithered out from under the bed. The second monster rasped, "I'm Cynthia." Much better, I thought. When I saw the jagged claws, Cynthia might be the perfect monster for Emma. But Emma blinked and said, "Pretty!" Then she decorated Cynthia's tail with beads and bracelets. "Ugh," Cynthia snarled, "I'm not here to play dress up. I'm here to scare you to bed." Cynthia rattled loudly. But Emma danced to the beat. "I'm sorry, Cynthia. This isn't going to work."
"Well, I never,"
she sniffled, and then she was gone. So, how many monsters was that now?
Two.
And he's got one more chance.
"Cynthia, come back!"
Emma demanded, stomping on the floor. Excellent, I thought. Maybe that would summon the perfect monster for Emma. Tentacles swarmed out from under the bed and an icy voice called, "Ooh!" And I shrank back in horror. But Emma was enchanted. "Who's out of bed?" the monster continued. "Come to Vladimir!" Emma high-fived one of the tentacles and the third monster emerged. Emma's not scared of anything. I already had doubts about this one, but it was my last chance. "Vladimir," I asked, "can you get Emma to sleep?"
"Yes," he hissed, reaching for Emma. "I can get her."
Emma giggled and hop-roped over with his tentacles like jump ropes. "Oh, no," I blurted. "She's not supposed to be having fun. This will never work." Blast tentacles dropped and he slunk under the bed and he was gone. "Sorry, Vlad," I called. Boy, was I sorry. I was about to lose Gay forever. Now Emma was coloring and singing, "Blah, blah, Blabamir, Cynthia, yah, yah. Agapapa." Gabe must have heard her because he was back.
"That's it, kid," he grunted. "You had your three tries. Now it's my turn."
Gabe's green ooze sizzled across the floor as he growled,
"Put the crayon down."
Emma peered at my hulking, shark-clawed monster and said, "Fuzzy!" "What?" Gabe burst out from under the bed, loomed over Emma, and steam spurted from his ears. "Get into bed!" Gabe thundered. Can y'all see Emma? Is she worried at all about this big fuzzy monster? Emma hopped up, but she kept singing, "Fuzzy, fuzzy monster." "Gabe," I said, "Emma's not scared enough to fall asleep. Please, let's go back to my room."
"No can do, kid," Gabe growled. "I may not be the perfect monster for Emma, but I'm the best so far. At least she's in bed now. I gotta stay here. You're on your own."
I knew Emma needed Gabe, but he was my monster. How was I ever going to get to sleep without him? Just then, we heard a tiny noise. Emma froze. Gabe and I peered under the bed.
"Stella, what are you doing here?"
Gabe asked.
"Hi, Gabe,"
Stella said, tugging at her tutu. "You forgot your snack. Mama thought you'd get hungry, so she sent this."
Who knew?
Gabe had a little sister, too. I thought Stella's hiccups were cute, but Emma obviously didn't.
Stella sure noticed as she tiptoed closer,
hiccuping with every step. From under her covers, Emma squeaked, "Shoo!" That scares her.
"Shoo!"
Stella repeated. "That's where toes go, and I love toes!" Stella crept toward Emma's feet. Emma squealed and scratching her feet and giggled, "No toes! No toes!" Gabe laughed.
"Stella, looks like you're the perfect monster for Emma. Now, if you don't mind, you can get her to sleep while I get back to what I do best."
Stella nodded. Sighed with relief, and I switched off Emma's lamp. Then I ran to my room, leaped in the back bed, and scrunched in my feet so Gabe couldn't get my toes. I shivered happily. Emma had Stella, and I had Gabe. Everything was back to normal. I shivered again. We'd all be asleep in no time. Did y'all like that?
Yeah.
That was a cool story. Now, you guys are going to get to do something awesome because y'all get to make your very own silly monsters. Y'all ready to do that? Okay, let's go.